I got the handcuffs on, right? And I'm much smaller now. I'm small now, but I'm much, much, much smaller then. So I got the handcuffs on. So I'm like, man, when this nigga walk past me one more time, I'm taking these bitches off and I'm running.
A criminal grind, nigga. A criminal grind mean hustle. You know, we trade war stories. We outlaws on the rise. Jealous niggas I despise. Look in my eyes. We trade war stories. We outlaws on the...
I can remember listening to Compton's Most Wanted. Was it Music the Drive-By I was listening to? Yeah, I think it was Music the Drive-By I was listening to. And like I said on the previous... War story, I had told you my mom had moved out Virginia Beach. She had moved down this middle class place called College Park. You know, it wasn't hood or nothing like that. It was in Virginia Beach. It's like it's out the way. It's like it's a little ways from the hood. But you know, she had got herself together this time, so she working, she doing hell. She good this time. I'm a grown man down there though, so I'm in the streets now. Right before she had left and went to work, she was like, Thomas, cause my older brother Red, he was in that's another story too, about them breaking in the bakery and shit. But he was already in prison. So her word to me that morning was, Thomas, if you don't get yourself together, you're gonna wake up and find yourself in penitentiary. Those were her words to me that morning. You can't hear that shit. You're not listening to that shit. You really can't hear it. So she left on out and went to work. And so I put my clothes on. I'm listening to Music to Drive By. Put my clothes on. I just said went and got a sweater with a picture of me sitting on my car there. I got a Bergen & Sterling this time with chrome rims up there, the wide rims. And I had just went and got a sweater that night. Me, Nicole, and Duke, I think, went to the mall. So I got that, put it on the sweater. So I put my sweater on and my coconut jeans. And my mom had already left and I head out. My hair bushy. I hit in the road. So I'm on my way to school, actually. They had put me out of Lake Teller. They put me out, so I was going to like this alternative school called Madison. So I'm driving, I'm listening to motherfucking Spice One. I just got finished listening to MCA in the house, so now I want to get some Spice One in me, so I'm listening to the 187 Fat. Yeah, the one with the album with Trigger Got No Heart. So I'm hitting in the road, so I say, fuck it, let me motherfucking go get my hair braided before I go to school. So the girl I was kicking with at the time, she stayed right in the hood. Keisha, she stayed right in the hood. So I stop over there on my way to school. It's early in the morning. So stop over there. So I'm beating the horn, but it's jive early. So I guess she's still asleep. So I'm beeping the motherfucking horn. So she don't never come. So I'm like, fuck it. So I jump back in the car. Soon as I hit the corner on Liberty Street, I'm ready to make a left, but it's a car park right there. So I really can't see the cars that's coming. I can see the cars coming this way, but I can't see the cars coming this way because there's a truck parked right on the corner. So after I wait for a few, I'm like, fuck, I'm going to just go on and shoot out there. So as I'm turning out, Blue and White, Norfolk Fine is coming up. So they like to hit me because I couldn't see him. So he immediately get behind me. He busts a U-turn, immediately get behind me. I turn, I'm right there by the corner store. I turn right and shop and go. He pulled me over. Now, at this time, I got motherfucking four outstanding warrants. But the thing about it was all dumb shit. They was all yellow sheets. I had four motherfucking yellow sheets. You know, different cities had different things. So yellow sheets is misdemeanor. I ain't had no green sheets, all yellow sheets. So it was all dumb shit. I got four motherfucking yellow sheets. All dumb shit. All misdemeanors. The first motherfucking one, it was a gun charge. I caught a gun charge Christmas Day. Me and Head, rest in peace, Head. The Ironworker Hall, they had some shit there. Some they had a reggae night or something like that. I think dude from my way, his band, he was in a reggae band. They was playing that night. So I think I decided to go by myself. So dude from around my way named Bull, he had a 22. It was literally this big, 22 this big, five shots. And you literally can stick it in your fucking shoe. That's how small it was. And you know, after Juice, everybody wanted to put a fucking gun in their shoe or their boot, including me, starting with me. Everybody wanted to be Bishop and be sweet and put a fucking gun in their shoe. So I went and got Bull 22. I got a half ounce of reefer, stopped on Walker, and turned on Liberty. They pulled me right over, boom. So I don't have a license, so I get out the car. Make a long story short, they find the fucking gun, but don't find the weed. Take me to jail Christmas Day. My record clean now, because I'm just turning into an adult. I don't have an adult record. So they take me to fucking jail Christmas Day. They give me a PI bond. Only thing I had to do was go in there. I got out in about 2 hours, fingerprint processing, whatever. They gave me a PI bond, which is a personal reconnaissance bond where you sign out and say you got to go to court. Boom. Second motherfucking green sheet was we in the mall one day. A little bit before this time, because it's jive around Christmas time. It ain't Christmas yet. We in the mall one day. Me, JJ, Joking Joe, I think my brother, somebody else. So JJ and fucking Joe, they bullshitting. This one towards us was right there beside Sports Fantasies, for people who remember the old military circle. Towards us was right there by Sports Fantasies. So they just bullshitting. JJ got, he full the fuck up. You know what I mean? Joe doing this thing. So everybody got money. They just bullshit though, taking teddy bears, throwing them out the store. Just bullshit for no reason. Joe started that crazy shit. He taking teddy bears, just putting them on the side of the store because he could. So he putting a teddy bear there, putting another teddy bear there. Just keep fucking with the people teddy bears for no reason. So I'm watching these crazy motherfuckers. I'm tripping. These niggas crazy. JJ crazy and Joe crazy. So I guess somebody pinned it and called the motherfucking police. So now the police come, they hem me up. They got all us up against the wall, but I won't doing shit. So I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with y'all? So now we bucking, JJ buck, make a long story short. They ain't take nobody to jail, they just write, I don't even know if they got summonses. I don't know, but I know I got a summons for disorderly conduct, for, you know, acting crazy, because I really was mad because I won't doing this shit and they fucking with me. But I'm with them though. That's another signature I got to go to court for. Boom. The third green sheet, I couldn't go back to the fucking mall until that case was over with. So one day, me and Breon, we stayed in the Motel 6. It's across from the mall. So that morning time, we walked the military circle to jump in the cab. Why the dumb pussy-ass security guards from the mall see me and notice me from weeks before, from I was supposed to be on the property until the case was over with. So now they bust a U-turn, come get me and fucking with me. Like, you don't supposed to be on the property. You know, they call the police. So they got them and grab me again and fucking arrest me. They give me a trespassing charge. So Breon going crazy. Rest in peace. That's my nigga. He going crazy. He think I'm going to jail. He running around. He looking for me. Because they take me to their, like, little security shit. Like, little shit they got going on. They take me to their security shit and give me another month trespassing. I ain't even finished with the fucking teddy bear shit yet. We chill in the shop and go one day. We up there bullshitting. And I got some weed in my pocket. They walked straight up to me, grabbed me, put me on the fucking car. Ain't asked me nothing, no ID, but you ignorant to the law. You don't know no fucking better. You know, you learn as you go. But they walk up to me, grab me, put me on the fucking car, search me, go right in my pocket, get some weed out. Like, fuck, I forgot all about I had this shit in there. So I'm like, damn. So Didi, you know, she used to be at the store fucking with us. You know, she a OG in the gang and shit. So she like, Sneak, don't worry about that shit. Ain't nothing but weed. They ain't gonna do this. They ain't gonna do that to you. So I'm like, all right. So they wrote me a summons. That's the fourth. I go to court for all these motherfuckers. And actually, I did go to court. But just being young and dumb and ignorant, just when you ignorant, man, you just aware, you unaware of the problems that you cause yourself. Because all of this shit could have been avoided. It was all misdemeanors. All the shit was misdemeanor, but I didn't see my name on the docket when I went to court. So instead of going to the clerk office like I would you know, would have did later on in life. I didn't see my name on the docket, so I just left. Like, fuck y'all. Just, you know, probably not even fuck y'all. Just, you know, just being dumb about the whole situation and left. So now I take you back to me driving. So when he pulled me over, now the shit, ding, ding, boy, you got these motherfucking warrants. So I never rode around with an ID then because I'm just turning grown. Like, that shit was like, it wasn't really no need for me to have an ID. I didn't have a license. So he asked me my name. I gave him my brother name. Always use my brother name for anything. Like, that's another ignorant thing. Get him, his name is some shit. Get him fucked up for shit I'm doing. So I used his name. So when he asked me what's my social security number, I was like, I don't know it. So I'm driving a Bergen Sterling, young ass boy driving a Bergen Sterling with these fucking rims up there and with this music in there, clean. So I rolled the window down and I'm like, man, I don't know my social security number, but I gave him my brother name. So he on gang though. He was like, all right, roll the windows up. So he rolled the windows up, tell me get out, put me in the back of the car. We're like, who car is this? No, before he do that, he was like, who car is this? I said, this is my girlfriend's car. She stayed right there and we can go up there. Cause she stayed, not the one house that I went and got my hair braided at. I was messing with her too, but the other girl stayed like a block up. And this was my main girlfriend where I used to get her thing, her name, cause she was older. She was a little much older. She probably was like 20, I'm 18, 17, 18. She probably was like 26, maybe 27, but like 26. So I'm like, this is my girlfriend's car. She stayed right here, which she did. So this smart ass motherfucker said, okay, kept me in the car, drove me up to her house. What's the address? I say right there, 1009, right there. So he went and got her. He was like, is such and such here? So her mom went and got her. She came outside. She was like, what's his name? He asked her, what's his name? And I'm in the back. I'm trying to get it. There's no fucking way she can hear my fucking mouth, read my lips, what I'm saying. I'm trying to tell her, Melvin, say my brother's name. She can't hear me what the fuck I'm saying. I'm sitting all the way in the back car. She goddamn 10 feet away. But my dumb ass thinking she'll be able to hear me. So she telling my name. So he was like, that's not the name that he gave me. So he come back to the car. I guess he figured he got something. Now he come back to the car, ran my name. He was like, oh, okay, I see why you don't know your social security number. You got 4 outstanding warrants. You going to jail, buddy. So I'm like, damn. Now I'm like, fuck. So I'm done with you, ma'am. You can go ahead. So I'm thinking like, okay, it might not be too bad, you know, because I really want to wear or the failure to appear shit. You're done. So we bust a U-turn. So now when we going back down Liberty Street, the girl house that I initially went over to get my hair braided, I was just talking about, now they outside. Now she want to come outside. So her and the other girl outside standing right on the script. So when I ride past, I just wave at them. So they bust out laughing. So take me to fucking jail. Boom. And now I've been down there before, but I got right back out. So this is a total situation. I'm going upstairs now. So goddamn, I get upstairs. They where they say, you know, no bond, you got fair to appear, you go to court tomorrow morning. So, you know, you listen to the dumbass niggas, man, they gonna give you a bond tomorrow. So I get up there, my homeboy Mice up there. I think Youngblood was up there too. They had just got caught on some dumb shit because we all in the misdemeanor tank. So everybody that's in the misdemeanor tank, you in there for some dumb shit, trespassing, whatever, dumb. With my situation different, I got fair to appeals. So I'm in there, I'm like, Mice, man, you think they gonna let me go? I'm asking everybody that motherfucker, man, you think they gonna let me go, man, tomorrow morning, man, when I go to court? So some people saying yeah, and some people saying no. So Youngblood and that motherfucker, ear. Youngblood from the hood, he from, you know, he an older dude, Youngblood and that motherfucker, ear. I keep burning the shit out of him every 5 minutes. I know he's saying, man, if you don't get the fuck from around me with that crying ass shit, every 5 minutes, Youngblood, man, you think they gonna give you think they gonna let me go tomorrow, man? They ain't gonna let me go. So I know he got them and he like, man, if you don't leave me the fuck alone, I'm warning him every 5 minutes. So Mice in there too. So back then, in the holding tank, people can call in there. You know what I'm saying? So actually, another girl that I was messing with, Mice was messing with her homegirl. So we was messing with 2 homegirls and shit. So he called me to the phone, man. Yo, man, Tina on the phone, man. So everybody asking, man, you all right? The word done got around already, though, man. Motherfucker asking, you all right, man? You good? What's going on? So, you know, I'm telling them, I'm jive, because I'm new to this motherfucking, this opiate shit. I'm jive new to it, so I know that I'm feeling bad, but I really don't know the effects of it. This when I first seen roll-ups, you know what I'm saying? I'm thinking motherfuckers smoking weed. I ain't never seen you roll up cigarettes and paper and shit. So then I'm like, damn, they're blowing weed. But I'm like, I'm fucked up. So I don't even, if it was weed, I don't even want it. So Mike's holding me down, you know, because he a vet at this shit. I'm new. So he making sure, you know, I'm all right. You know what I mean? You know, like I say, people calling. If you got your change, you can get them and use phone calls. So different people calling. You meeting new people and shit. You know how that shit is. You know, you meet people from all over. You know, everybody talking about what they in there for. And, you know, I'm still asking motherfuckers, do you think I'm a goddamn get out? Like I said, I'm new to this shit. So when they finally called me, they called me in there. My mom and them ain't there at the time. I don't know what's going on. They just called me in there, blah, 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 snatched me right out. So I don't know what's going on. So I'm like, man, did I get a bond? I don't know. So now I got to go to traffic court too because he caught me driving. So I done came from general district criminal. I done came from low court. So now I got to go downstairs to traffic. So like I said, they took me in, took me right out. So I still don't know if I got a bond or not. I don't know what's going on. So when I get downstairs, my mom and them there. So I'm feeling a little relief then. You know what I mean? My hair fucking out. I ain't never get my hair done. I got the hoodie on, Concordize, and the black Air Force One. So my mama sitting back there, my brother sitting back there, somebody else. It was like four people. So the judge was a real nice judge. He was a traffic judge. So I'm handcuffed to somebody else. So we go in there, both of us handcuffed each other. So he looking at me. I guess he knew, goddamn it. He looked at me like, this got to be his first time. I won't, but 18 years old. Like, this got to be his first time. So he was like, well, for some reason, whatever, they didn't give you a bond in traffic court. And the deputy walking back and forth past me the whole time. He keep walking back and forth. So he like, son, whatever reason they didn't give you a bond in general district court, I don't know. But whenever you get that matter taken care of, you got a PR bond here, so don't worry about it. You don't have to pay no money. You can get out on your own signature. So I'm looking around. I'm like, I don't got no bond. Deputy's like, no, you don't got no bond upstairs, but he gonna give you one downstairs.
My mama told me when I was younger, my slow ass daddy ran out of the courtroom with handcuffs on, trying to escape out of the police line. He's about to go in front of the judge, and he ran out the courtroom, slid out the handcuffs, and ran out the courtroom. It was the talk of the town, like.
Courtroom. I don't know how he got away from them people with them handcuffs and shit on him and ran out that courtroom. But that crazy motherfucker ran up out that courtroom and got them and damn near got him. Man, I say this boy crazy as a motherfucker, man. Only him would do some crazy shit like that there. Because I had seen him uptown running around with a big 350 CM just a couple days ago. But that nigga sneak, he definitely ran out that motherfucking courtroom.
So all night after I've been asking all these motherfuckers, worrying people to death, and now I'm finally knowing that I'm not gonna get no bond. I'm like, oh, hell no, what the fuck? So I look back there at my mom and them, and I'm like, man, what the hell? Ain't no way in hell I'm going back up there in that nasty motherfucker. It's no way. So, like I said, I'm small as a bitch. So I say, yeah, damn, I can get out these motherfuckers. But he walking back and forth past me. I'm hooked to somebody now, no shackles. Now you gotta wear shackles and your clothes. So I'm hooked to a motherfucker. So I said, I can get out these. So I said, okay, when he walked back past me, I'm gone. He walked back that way. I took that motherfucker out and bowled that nigga like, get the fuck out my way, and took off. My mom was like, Thomas, no, yo, boom. So when I get out, I'm looking which way to go. I don't know which way to go. I mean, traffic court, I'm downstairs. I don't know which way to go. I've never been to court, adult court, this is my first time. So he's got deputies out there. You got everybody out there. You got people looking at the docket. You got everybody out there. So once I hit the door, boom, they hear the commotion like, you son of a bitch. That's what he said when I hit him and ran, you son of a bitch. So now they hear the commotion, so with the protector looking at the docket. So I ran straight into him. His uncoordinated goof ass jumped up and tackle me. I knock him down, boom. But he grabbed the goddamn the pockets of my hoodie, and that shit just ripping like a football player. I'm dragging, and that shit ripping. And then they just fucking jumped on me. I'm talking about like 50 of them motherfuckers. So they roughing me up. They sneaking blows in. So they really get off on me because my mom and them out there. So they like, everybody get back. Everybody get back. Get out of here. Get out of here. So fucking when they took me in the back, they really got off on. They really got off on me. They ain't fucked me up, but they roughed me up. They did me dirty. So they take me back to the medical. So I'm breathing hard as a bitch. I'm beat up. I'm breathing. So they like, I'm like, man, I'm withdrawing off heroin. He was like, well, good. Now your ass here for good. You can ride out now. You can dry out. No, that's what he said. We're like, good. Now your ass can dry out. You here for good now. They was like, dress him out. They ain't even put me in the holding cell. They were like, dress him out and put him in post 7. Post 7 was like the dungeon. It's 6 cells in the front and 6 cells in the back. Round nothing. No TV. You in the middle of fucking nowhere. I was down there. You know what I'm saying? I had to adjust to that shit. I adjusted. You know what I'm saying? I got used to it. I adjusted. And I can remember the radio. The only thing was playing was, lay your head on my pillow. I hate you so much right now. Motherfucking Wu-Tang Clan, Ice Cube, How Do We Do It? Snoop Doggy Dogg, Doggy Style. On there, I met this dude named Sonny Smith. His name was Tyson. He loves staying down there. If they take him from down there and put him up on the floor, he gonna fight to get back down there. And need one man, Keisha writing me every day. I got Tina writing me every day. I got my baby mama writing me. I got motherfucker Diane, that was my old lady. She got them to write me, so got them at Diane and Keisha, they coming to see me, they bump my head. So I'm telling one of them, you gotta go. So my mama, so once she found out that I'm all right, she good now, cause they first come and see me. She was like, Thomas, don't make that girl do that. I'm like, Mom, she gotta go. She know she ain't my, you know what I mean? She got, so she walk out looking stupid as hell, man. She got a whole thing of boxers, t-shirts, underwear for me. So my mom was like, Thomas, That ain't right, but shit. Damn, my lady, my car, everything was in her name, and I left her with everything. Every time I come out for showers, handcuffed, wherever I go, I'm handcuffed. I actually got used to it. I actually got used to the shit. So my sister, daddy, he was in jail at this time. He was on the 8th floor. He was in the program block. So, you know, he one of those ones that, you know, he go to jail. He been going to jail a lot, so he get good in with the classification people. You know, they know him. You know, he run the programs for him. He one of them. Shout out to DJ. So he was in there. That's my sister dad. He was in there. So he talked to the classification man. He was like, you know, told him that's my son. You know, well, I don't know exactly what he told him, but like I said, I'm used to this shit now. I'm used to it. So, one day they called me like, clarification, won't you? So I got to put the shockers on. They treated me like I was goddamn Timothy McVeigh, some motherfucking body. I was used to the shit. I kind of really didn't want to go, but I knew everybody was on the floor. So I get up on the floor. I'm goddamn wearing the motherfucking phone out so much. My old lady's sister done blocked the calls. You could eat, niggas go to jail and get back. I'm talking about niggas go to jail. When they leave out, when they fucking finally get released or whatever, they can't even fit the shit that they came in with. That's how good they used to feed your motherfucking ass. Still got this 5 years beating in my motherfucking head that I think I'm a motherfucking get. Finally go to court, I got Robinson. So I get in there and he came back there. He was like, man, cause he been told me, like, man, you ain't escape. You ain't going nowhere. I'm going to get this shit dropped to a misdemeanor. So he told me that, like, prior before I went to court. So when I go to court, he was like, man, they fighting, man. They don't want to drop it to a misdemeanor. So I'm like, damn, fuck. So I'm just like, what the fuck going on? You know what I'm saying? So I had a feeling that I wasn't going to go home that day. So I had went to court for the other shit, and they had gave me 90 days. I went to court, like, 2 weeks before this. And they had gave me 90 days for the gun and the weed and all that shit. No, they gave me 6 months. 6 months you don't do, but 3 months. So they gave me 6 months for the gun and the weed and all that shit. So he said, I tell you what I'm going to do. He go back in there. He came back. He was like, look, the gun dropped it to a misdemeanor, but you still got 45 more days to do anyway. You know what I'm saying? So they're going to drop it to a misdemeanor. We're going to give you 6 months, and we're going to run a concurrent with your gun charge and the weed charge that you already got. So that means you'll be goddamn it going home in like 45 days, right at the summer. I'll be going home, like I went home May. So I was like, okay, bet, let's do it. 45 more days, fuck it. I get to go talk to my homeboy, Breon. You know, he up there for a robbery and fucking malicious wounding. So he on his way to penitentiary. So I knew I wasn't gonna see him for a while. So I like, fuck it, okay. So I get my old lady to go out there and get weed. They out there washing the car. So she'll come and get them weed. They'll come in, pass the weed under the motherfucking door. So we in there getting high as a motherfucker. Me and my nigga, Marvie Scales from Curry Park. We got them and we blowing every day I'm going to get them. So yeah, that's what happened, man. They dropped it to a misdemeanor and gave me 6 months. Ran a concurrent to what I already had. When you're young and ignorant, you don't understand. You need to pay attention to how you can turn something this small, you know what I'm saying, to this big. You know what I'm saying? And it won't that serious at all. You know what I mean? That's the same thing to go on the streets, man. Motherfucker take 1 minute and throw their whole fucking life away, whether it's in the penitentiary or in the graveyard, by something so small, man, by just not thinking, being young and ignorant. And right to this day, when I was getting locked up later on, going to prison, I can't never get work release. I can't go to no work camps. I can't do none of that type of shit because of that dumbass decision that I made. That, you got to think about decisions that you make right now that will cost you later on. Because whatever seed you plant, that bitch gonna grow. That bitch gonna grow regardless of what it is. Whatever you plant, gonna grow, man.
I couldn't help but notice your pain.
My pain?
It runs deep. Share it with me.
Take me alive, I'm getting high with my 4-5. Cocked on these suckers, time to die, even as a youngster. Causing ruckus on the back of the bus. I was a fool all through high school, kicking up dust. But now I'm labeled as a troublemaker. Who can you blame? Smoking weed helped me take away the pain. So I'm hopeless, rolling down the freeway, swerving. Don't worry, I'm about to crash up on the curb. Cause my business bloody, maybe if they tried to understand me. What should I do? I had to feed my fucking family.